Take a look at our beautiful home, Earth. Now picture us zooming out. You see that tiny speck? That's still Earth. And this, well, this is UY Scuti, the largest star we've discovered so far. Feeling small yet? Don't worry, you're not alone. Welcome to the universe, where size is the rhythm that dictates the life, death, and destiny of stars. But before we dive into the deep end of the cosmic pool, let's start with something a bit closer to home. Our planet may seem pretty impressive with its diameter of about 7,917.5 miles. It's roomy enough to house all our bustling cities, towering mountains, and vast oceans. But in the grand scheme of the universe, Earth is a lightweight. If Earth were the size of a marble, UY Scuti would be larger than a hot air balloon. Now, if you think that's crazy, brace yourselves, because we're about to crank up the size dial to astronomical. This star, UY Scuti, the reigning heavyweight champion of the universe, resides in the constellation Scutum and makes our sun look like a speck of dust on a cosmic scale. So, how big is UY Scuti? This single star is so colossal that it could hold over 5 billion suns and 650 billion Earths. If you were to fly a plane around UY Scuti at a cruising speed of 550 miles per hour, it would take you over 1,200 years to complete one trip. It's like a never-ending road trip with no pit stops, not even for cosmic fast food. Remember, UY Scuti is just one star in a universe teeming with billions of galaxies, each home to billions of stars. If the universe were the size of the Earth, then our entire Milky Way galaxy would be smaller than a coffee cup, and our solar system would be no bigger than a grain of sand. So next time you're feeling big, just remember, in the grand cosmic ballet, we're all just doing the cha-cha on a microscopic dance floor. It makes every moment we have much more precious. So let's savor each moment in this vast cosmic dance and never stop reaching for the stars, or at least the nearest cosmic snack bar. Now, you might be wondering, what does all this size mean? Well, let's dive into the nitty-gritty. Starting with gravity, you might think UY Scuti's enormous size would produce a gravity that would flatten you into a pancake. But remember, size isn't the same as mass. UY Scuti, like other supergiant stars, is incredibly bloated, with much of its mass spread out over a large volume. So if you could stand on its surface, which you can't because it's a raging ball of gas, not a solid, the gravity you'd experience would be less than you'd expect. But let's not get any ideas about zero-gravity space vacations just yet. We wouldn't want you floating away with your space snacks. Next, we have lifespan. In a cosmic twist of irony, the biggest stars have the shortest lives. Stars burn through their fuel at a furious rate, living fast and dying young in astronomical terms. While our sun enjoys a leisurely lifespan of about 10 billion years, a star like UY Scuti is more of a sprinter than a marathon runner. It might only last a few million years before it exhausts its nuclear fuel and goes out with a bang, like a grand final firework at the end of a spectacular show. Now let's pivot from the lifespan of stars to another fascinating aspect, brightness and color. You might intuitively think that the bigger the star, the brighter it shines. However, the universe loves to defy our expectations. The brightness of a star is a dance between its size and its temperature. Take UY Scuti, for instance. Despite its size, it's relatively cool for a star, with a surface temperature of about 3,365 Kelvin. That's less than 60% of the sun's surface temperature. This cooler temperature gives UY Scuti a reddish hue. It's far from the brightest star in the sky, but if it replaced the sun in our solar system, its surface would extend past the orbit of Jupiter, and we'd definitely notice its red glow. It's like the universe's version of a red light district, but without the neon signs. But if we ever want to see this gigantic star in person, how can we even get there? Well, this massive star is located about 9,500 light years away from us. But what's a light year, you ask? It's the distance that light, the fastest thing in the universe, travels in one year. That's a whopping 5.88 trillion miles. It's like driving to the grocery store, only if the grocery store was located beyond the farthest reaches of our universe. So you might want to bring a good playlist, or a few million. And a toothbrush? At this point, you might as well bring a lifetime supply of dental floss too. But before we get too carried away with our interstellar road trip preparations, let's consider what we face once we actually hit the road, or rather, the cosmic highway. As we leave Earth's atmosphere and venture into the vast expanse of space, we'd encounter a multitude of challenges. Contrary to popular belief, space is not as empty as it seems. We'd have to dodge asteroids, comets, and other cosmic debris. It's like the universe's version of an obstacle course. And let's not forget about the harmful radiation in space. Our spaceship would need some serious shielding. Think of it as the universe's most extreme sunscreen. Now, let's imagine we're on our spaceship, zooming past stars and galaxies. Even at the speed of light, the journey would be incredibly long. This is due to a mind-bending phenomenon known as time dilation, where time slows down as you approach the speed of light. So while we might age only a few years on the spaceship, thousands of years would pass on Earth. Talk about a serious case of jet lag. You'd return to find everyone you know has been dead for millennia. On the bright side, you'd have the best what I did on my vacation story ever. Now let's take that imagination of yours for another spin. What if we lived on a planet orbiting a colossal star like UY Scuti? Well, this isn't your regular Sunday drive around the sun. Any planet daring enough to orbit this stellar behemoth would need to keep a safe distance to avoid being vaporized. This means the planet's year, its orbit around the star, could last for centuries. Your birthday would come around less often than an Avatar movie, and that's saying something. But here's where things get really interesting. Could life exist on a planet orbiting such a giant star? Some scientists think it's within the realm of possibility. Life on Earth thrives in some pretty extreme environments, from the crushing depths of ocean trenches to the scorching heat of volcanic vents. So who's to say life couldn't adapt to the conditions on a planet orbiting a giant star? However, you might wonder, how do these giant stars even come into existence? What's the secret recipe for cooking up a cosmic titan like UY Scuti? Stars are like celebrities. They're born from humble beginnings, but they quickly rise to fame in a spectacular display of cosmic creation. Picture a cloud of gas and dust collapsing under its own gravity, and voila, a star is born. But stars are not just pretty faces in the sky. They're nuclear powerhouses producing energy through a process called nuclear fusion. This energy is what keeps them shining as brilliantly as a star on the grand stage of the universe. As stars evolve over time, their size plays a crucial role in determining their fate. In this cosmic version of Hollywood, being the right size often determines whether you get the big roles. So what does this mean about our star of the show? This red supergiant is not going to just fade away quietly. No, sir. It's going to go out with a bang, literally. Imagine fireworks on the 4th of July, but a million times bigger. It is destined to explode as a supernova, an event so powerful that it would outshine an entire galaxy. It's like winning an Oscar, but instead of thanking your agent, you're thanking the laws of physics. But supernova are not just pretty explosions. They're like cosmic factories that produce many of the elements that make up our world. It's like a fashion designer creating a new line of clothing, except instead of clothes, they're making gold, silver, and other precious metals. So, next time you're admiring a gold necklace, remember that gold was likely made in a supernova. Talk about a cosmic connection. It's like wearing a piece of the universe around your neck. Now, while it's been fun relaxing in the golden glow of UY Scuti's grandeur, it's time we introduce you to some of its equally impressive celestial neighbors. After all, the cosmic sea is teeming with other giants, each with their own unique stories to tell. So let's set sail and meet some of the other big players on the celestial stage. First on the list is VY Canis Majoris, a red hypergiant star that's approximately 1,800 times larger than our Sun. If VY Canis Majoris decided to move into our neighborhood and replace our Sun, its surface would extend so far out that it would engulf all the inner planets and even reach the asteroid belt. Not as big as UY Scuti, but you'd need a spaceship and a packed lunch just to get to the outer edge of this star. It's like going on a road trip where the next rest stop is a few planets away. Next, we have Beetlejuice, a star you might recognize as the shoulder of Orion, one of the most recognizable constellations in the night sky. This star is a modest 700 times the size of our Sun. I say modest with a healthy dose of cosmic irony, of course. It's still a giant in its own right, like a bodybuilder next to a gymnast. But Beetlejuice isn't just known for its size. It's also a variable star, meaning its brightness changes over time. Sometimes it's one of the brightest stars in the sky, and other times it dims significantly. This is because Beetlejuice is a red supergiant nearing the end of its life, and these brightness changes are a result of complex, internal processes happening within the star. And on top of this, Beetlejuice is expected to explode as a supernova in the next 100,000 years or so. When it does, it will briefly outshine even the moon and be visible during the day. I don't know about you, but I'm not sure if I'm looking forward to that. It's going to be pretty bright, and I'm not sure if I'm ready for the world to see me in my pajamas. Now, let's bring it back home for a second. Our sun, the star we know and love, is a relatively small star compared to these giants. It has a diameter of about 1.4 million kilometers, which is about 109 times smaller than the diameter of VY Canis Majoris. It's like comparing a poodle to an elephant. We love our sun, but size-wise, it's not winning any awards in the cosmic competition. We've journeyed from our home planet to the far reaches of space, encountering some of the universe's largest stars along the way. Through our comparison of these stars to UY Scuti, Earth, and our own sun, we gain a better understanding of the incredible scale of the universe. But this is just the beginning. The universe is a vast, fascinating place, full of mysteries waiting to be uncovered. We encourage you to keep exploring, keep learning, and keep looking up at the stars. If you enjoyed this cosmic journey, please like and subscribe to our channel, and share this video with your fellow space enthusiasts. As we end this journey, we leave you with a question to ponder. If the universe is so vast and filled with stars much larger than our sun, what other cosmic wonders might be waiting out there for us to discover? Remember, the universe is a grand stage, and we've only just pulled back the curtain.